And I'm back. I think in this stage of our painting, it is a good plan to make a shirt for her, because then we know with the finishing touches where that's going to be. I like to make my girls just a regular simple shirt, just like this, something like this. And I'm going to paint her shirt just now. I just need to think about a color. I think I'm going to add something about that two colors. That's my ultramarine and my pink color. We are going to mix them. I'm getting a little bit on my palette of them. And I'm going to take a little bit of a larger brush like this. And I'm going to dip into my ultramarine. Let me see, I need to make some space. Just like this, so. And I'm randomly going to paint and adding different colors to it. So I'm adding along the way, not only the blue, but I also add a little bit of that pink color too. Clean your brush if it is necessary. I like this and I blend this too. It is not that it stays that just one color. I like to blend it and to like to mix those colors so that it's not just one color that is in her shirt. I think that is much more beautiful. I need to add a little bit of my pink. I did switch my brush to a smaller brush where I can, some of my old brushes, where I can blend a little bit better. Just by feeling, no rules about it, just add some color, even some white if you like to. I'm going to add some white too. And if you look, there was still coming something through from the stenciling, and I think that's great. That's just what I like to do, to have a lot of layers, a lot of interest from the background to everything I paint. I think that's really, really lovely. Don't be picky, don't be too perfectionism. Just add a layer, add color, add white if you want to, just like I'm doing. Use your fingers if necessary. I like it this way. By making it round right here, it indicates that it's coming from the back over to the shoulders and to the front. Okay. I think I'm going very quickly take a stencil My flower stencil, lay it over. Take a baby wipe and go over it. And maybe it's not too late. Let me see. Yes, it's working. We can do something like this. I like to like this technique too. By removing some of the paints. Let me see. Removing some of the paints, it brings some extra interest to her shirt, her blouse. It doesn't need to be perfect, this. That's going to be fun. I will completely let this dry. I think that's lovely. Okay. We need to let this layer dry. And, of her shirt, I mean. I just want to wipe away this. Okay. And I'm thinking if we should do her hair first, or if we are going to add layers with our portfolios. This is a very cheap brand. These oil pastels are water soluble oil pastels. I don't ever use them with water. I just smear them with my fingers. And this is a very cheap brand. It's really, really cheap. I like to work with them. If you don't have portfolios, you can add, I do that too. I love to do that too. You can add color pencils. I have the Prismacolor portrait colors. You can add that too. Or I have some colors from the Darwent pencils. You can add those too. But I, in this class, I'm going to teach, I'm going to add some portfolio colors in a minute. I think it is maybe we are first going to do her hair, because then she becomes a real girl. And I think that is very important for her face. At this stage, I really don't have any idea what hair color I want to use. I have no idea. I'm just going to make her jawline a little bit. If your jawline is also a little bit disappeared, then you can add a little bit of graphite too if you want to. Just a little bit. Just like that. Yes. And in this stage, I don't know which color hair. I think maybe I love black hair. I love black in my art anyway. So maybe I do some black hair. I just need to think for a minute. And try to feel what is the best thing that I could do for her. So I'm going to pause this video and I will be back in a minute. I am back. I did dry her shirt. It's completely dry by now. And I decided that we are going to make her... My girl is getting really long hair. I like that. I'm going to draw it first. And then we are going to paint it. And she gets black hair. Okay. How do you draw hair? For many people think that drawing hair is really difficult, and I had that too, and of course I had that too, and sometimes I still have. There are many hair dresses. You can use, you can make some big hair, just flowing over, just like that, flowing up this way, so. But I don't know, I think maybe I'll make some really long hair. Like this, and a little bit higher hair. I like that too, that if it is a little bit higher. That, of course, is not natural, because, okay, there are people who having really high hair, but in normal life, it is not natural to have really high hair if you have really long hair. So I decided to make her hair. Let me see, I need to bring you guys a little bit down. I'm very intuitive with my hair, and I'm just going to make it a little bit curly today. I'm going to let it with paint fall over her shirt, but for now I think this is okay. And I'm going a little bit over her forehead because naturally there would be hair. Just like this. On this side too. And if you wonder if I wear her ears, I really seldom, rarely make any ears. I don't like to make them. Maybe that's because I find it very difficult to draw any ears. So, okay. I'm going to make a little wash with my black gesso, and I need to look if I have a little thingy where I can make a wash. I need to set away some of my paints here. Okay, I'm going to take a small brush to start, and I'm taking some of my black gesso. I lay it beside, next to me, and I'm adding some water to it at first to make a little wash. A wash is just paint with water. That's a wash. And I'm, let me see, I make it a little bit wider so you can see the whole screen. I'm having a small rounded brush, just like this, and I'm going to draw with it. And just drawing the outer lines of the hair, very intuitive. Don't really, try to not stress about this part, because it is always, we can always adjust this part. It is not, it doesn't matter if it is not perfect in this stage. Just like that. And I'm doing it the other way around. Just small hair. Okay. Now on her forehead. I just on her forehead make it a little bit wavy, because naturally it wouldn't be very straight. And I'm going to fill in the whole hair with the wash. A little bit careful with her face. It would be a shame if you go in with the black and it goes wrong. So pay a little attention to that. But other than that, I'm really being very intuitive, and I'm trying to let the hair flow, just like hair does, just flow, just like that. And later on we are going to add some darker color, darker black of course, but I do it often with the wash, because it's very easy to do it with the wash. And if you do it with just a heavy bodied or a thick gesso paint, black paint, it's not really, I don't think that flows very good to make lovely lines. And then later on we can fill them in with or black gesso, or even if you are using another color, that's perfectly fine too. You don't need to add black. Many of you know I love black, so I'm turning my page just to not make any mistakes. I really love black in my art. I think it's very mysterious. I really like it a lot. But I know that many people are a little bit afraid of black in art. And that's okay too, if you need to. And I think immediately if she gets hair, she looks a little different. She becomes really a girl, and it's really, really different. not flow her hair on her shirt, like it would be if you imagine if you have long hair, then it would flow a little bit so over her shirt, and some parts are a little longer, some parts of hair, and some parts are a little bit shorter and more curly. Little bit thinner lines and thicker lines, that is always a good thing. Just like that. And just as I said later on, we are going to make it really dark, really black. But for now, this is okay. I think I'm going to make her hair a little bit higher. And I'm using the same paint. I'm drawing with the paint, just with the wash, I'm drawing with it. I like it. I think it's very easy this way. To make it look a little bit flow and I'm just adding a little bit water to my wash. And keep looking at your painting, keep adding paint there where you want a little bit more paint. I know at this stage. I think I need a little bit higher, just like that. And just do that. And if you don't like it, you can always add gesso over it if you don't like it. I'm always try to build that up and not at once make a little a really high hair, but I'm trying to build it a little bit up, and I think she's okay just now, just like she is now. I'm letting it this fully dry, and then I will be back and we are going to play with her face. And we need to think about her background too. Not too much thinking, but just try to feel what she looks like, what she wants, how she looks, wants to look, her background, where she comes from. Just like that. We let her completely dry now, and I will be back in a minute. Of course, I'm going to use my heat gun for it, and I will be back in a minute. And I'm back. I'm taking my portfolios. These are the colors. I really like to work with them. It's one of my latest obsessions. I think it adds really interest to a portrait, and let's have some fun with them. I will set them aside. Just let me see. Yes, this is a good way. Okay. How do I do that? It's really intuitive too, because I just like to have a lot of color in the face. These colors are really basic colors, and I just like to add some interest. I think we are adding something of the purple that is in her shirt too. I'm bringing you a little bit down for now. So, and I'm looking, I have several purples. This is the violet. I'm trying out just a little thingy, and it is almost the same color. And I'm going to add just randomly, just here and there. I'm just adding a little bit of color, and I'm with my fingers, I'm going to blend that. This This is such a fine way to make a portrait a little bit more interesting. And I think immediately it shows that it's getting more depth. And yeah, I like that. I just really like that. A little bit on the inside of the nose. I'm adding a little bit of darkness there with the same purple, just like that. On the other side I do the same thing. Sometimes I need to blend it into the eye, just like now. Otherwise I'm getting it all over at my nose, and that's not what I'm trying to achieve. On the other side here too, I'm just applying a little bit, and then I'm blending it with my finger. Really blending. If we lose some of the white of the eyes, that's not a problem at all. We can always bring that back and by adding some white paint. Now I'm going to take my white, just my white, and I'm going to make the bridge of her nose really white. Take care of your fingers. Be sure that you don't, if you are going to blend, make sure you don't have any purple or orange or any color on your finger if you are going to do it with white. So I'm going to clean my finger with a baby wipe. And now I'm going to blend this very carefully. I'm going to add a little bit of white to her cheeks. And I blend. You can hear it is, I need to work really hard, because of the clear gesso I put underneath it. And I don't mind that at all. I'm going to add a little bit on the upper eyelid of the white. You can make little circular movements to blend it out a little bit more. And remember, it doesn't need to be perfect. We are trying to achieve a very imperfect face. A little bit on her chin. Just a little bit. I'm going to add a little bit of pink. This is just regular pink. Just a little bit. To give it some extra interest and colors. Randomly, just here and there. Just a little bit. Just be brave and put something on her nose. Under her neckline. Just a little bit in the corners, and don't overthink it too much, just do it and just be brave, and it is just I can imagine how scary it must be if you never done this before, but I promise you it will be, you will love it, you really will love it. A tiny little bit of yellow, I'd like to add that too. At some spots. And keep on blending that. And I really don't overthink this. I just add some. I'm going over with my my crayon and I just apply. And I like it. I think this face gets so much more interest if you add just a little bit of color in it. And again, you can do this with any color. You can do it with paint too. The previous painting I did let you see is all done with paint. Nothing a crayon or anything like that. It's all just paint. Let me see. I need something of that. This is the violet again. I just want to have some darkness here. And just by blending it all together, it just becomes one. I'm wondering if I should give her color cheeks. I don't know. Because I like her this way too. A little bit under her lower lip, I'm adding a little bit of shadow to that too. Just a tiny little bit. And if I'm quiet and sitting down here and I'm just trying to figure out what she wants. If she needs a little bit more, if I need to add a little bit of a color, I really need to just going to add a little bit of color to the cheeks. I think she can have that. Just like that. Yes, that's perfect. Oops. Little bit of darkness here. Use your left finger if you need to, or your non-dominant finger. Let me see. I just want to add a little bit of pink into that lips, into her lips. To bring back the pink a little bit. Of course, it could be a bit difficult to blend this with your finger, but just be gentle and try to blend it a little bit. I myself like it if there are multiple colors in the lips. I think that's just fine. I'm taking a slate gray. Try to make that little shadow in her lower lip that I like. A little bit under her lip. And the sides a little bit. It's a bit tricky in the lips. If you don't have the confidence to do that, then it's okay. You don't need to. You can add it just with your paints. And of course, I'm adding a little bit of white using my pinky. Now I think she really becomes beautiful. A little bit of white into her neck. And I think maybe there she could use a little bit more of the violet color into her neck too. Just to bring back that color. Just on the sides here, from her shoulders, bring back a little bit of that purple color. And I'm even going to shade just here. Just like that. Because that would be naturally would be shaded over there. I think she could use a little bit more white to the upper eyelid. At least mine, my girl. Just like that. I'm bringing a little bit into her, the whites of her eye. A little bit on the top of her nose again. Use a clean finger. I really did need to remove a little bit of the white here. By the way, you can, if you use the portfolio pastels, you can wipe away any mistakes with a baby wipe. And now I think she is really beautiful. Maybe I'm going to be a little bit brave and adding a little bit white. Just here. Sorry, black. And over on this side too. Just apply a little bit. You can always add. Let me see if this is. Yes, I really like that. Okay. I think we are done with our crayons. And the next step we are going to do is we are going to, let me see. I need to get her whites into her eye. So I'm going to take my brush and my palette. And I'm going to add some white. Oops. And you can make it very girly with a lot of highlights in the eyes. And sometimes I just like to do one small little dot. And I'm going to do that today too. Just one small little dot. And then I need to make one more highlight, and that's just below. Just a small, tiny, little dot below the black. To give her some depth into her nose. And I'm going to add some white just here around her lips. Just a little bit. And I even like it to push something over it so that it is not that white. A tiny little bit of white again on the tip of her nose. Just a little bit. It's all about layering. You have different kind of highlights, really the really light one and the less light one. It's all about layering and all about being brave and trying to add things and remove things. And you can always go over it if you don't like it. That's just perfectly fine. It is really, really fine. I'm trying to decide if she needs eyelashes. At this stage, I don't think she needs that. So I'm not going to add it in this stage. We can always add it later on. But I don't think she needs eyelashes in this stage. I just want to give some extra interest in the background. I'm having a lot of oh my god, I can't find the word. Washi tapes. I'm sorry guys. I'm going to add some washi tapes. You can add whatever interest in the background you want. I mean, you can add collage, you can add anything. And I'm going to glue down my washi tapes because my washi tapes aren't that good anymore. And I always glue them down. So I'm going to take my soft gel matte medium from Golden and an old brush. And I'm going to apply some to my background, and I'm adding something. Just randomly, and even this, I don't overthink it. I just apply it. It's all just for a little bit of interest in the background. And I have no idea what I'm going to do with my, with our background. I in this stage, I really don't. And I haven't thought about that. I like this one too. I need to find the beginning of it. Please, come on. This is a really long one. I'm going to add it. And go over it with a little bit of gel medium. You can apply, you don't need to use gel medium from Golden. Any gel medium is fine. Maybe this one will do. Most of the washi tapes I use are very cheap ones and they are not really, 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 really sticky. So that's why I'm sealing them with gel matte medium. Just to be sure that they keep on sticking, keep on gluing down. Let me see. This one I like too. Use different colors, and in this stage I really don't think if it matches the background I'm going to make later on, because I don't know what I'm going to make. So I'm just applying it. It could be anything. It could be collage papers. It could be anything. So it's really not important what you apply, just to make some extra interest. I often collage the whole background, and I think maybe, and that is just coming up just right now, maybe I'm doing a transparent background and really black hair. That could be very, very lovely. The contrast of that is very lovely. I'm going a little bit over her hair. I'm just doing that, just because I can. And just, please, don't be afraid of that, about layering things. Oh. You can add a layer to over another washi tape, just like that. Okay, I think this is enough washi tape. This needs to dry a little bit. Maybe I'm not adding anything else, I think. I'm going to drink something, and then I'm going to dry this with the heat gun, and I will be back in a minute.